Warning. Stand by for countdown. Prepare audience for maximum impact. Full immersion begins in.
My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving me.
I'm a soul man,
no.
I'm a soul man.
Yes, I am.
I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man, Lord.
You couldn't be soul.
They see something that I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Up, up, seven, easy. There's a reason why, after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason, but you don't take me seriously.
Thank you.
See, they say that Angel Step Number 7 don't care about the people. But Angel Step Number 7 cares about the people because I'm bold enough to tell you the truth. And I don't give a damn if you give me a dime. I'm not looking for your money.
We are in a state of emergency.
Prejudice. Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
This is a story about control. My control. Control of what I say and control of what I do. And this time, I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready? I am, because it's all about control, and I've got lots of it.
I can't describe all the joy that I feel.
I'm not going to help nobody get something my Negroes don't have. If I'm going to die, I'll die now, right here fighting you. If I'm going to die, well, you my enemy. My enemy is a white people, not Viet Cong or Chinese or Japanese. You my opposer when I want freedom. You my opposer when I want justice. You my opposer when I want equality. You won't even stand up for me in America for my religious beliefs, and you want me to go somewhere and fight, but you won't even stand up for me here at home.
No, I don't worry. I tell you, I'm a man who believed that I died 20 years ago. And I live like a man who is dead already. I have no fear whatsoever of anybody.
It seems to me that white America must see that no other ethnic group has been a slave on American soil. That America freed the slave in 1863 through the Emancipation Proclamation, but gave the slaves no land. And at the same time, America was giving away millions of acres of land in the West and the Midwest, which meant that there was a willingness to give the white peasants from Europe an economic base. And yet it refused to give its black peasants from Africa, who came here involuntarily in chains and had worked free for 244 years, any kind of economic base. And so emancipation for the Negro was really freedom to hunger. And when white Americans tell the Negro to lift himself by his own bootstraps, it's a cruel jest to say to a bootless man that he ought to lift himself by his own bootstraps.
I'm saying that the Nation of Islam should evolve into what we call the reality's temple on earth.
Emergency.
emergency.
Prejudice. Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
Keep it real.
What, dear?
Because I keeps it real like that.
I keeps it real.
It's your clothing. You just keep it going.
I am also your soul brother, number one.
In one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for, a change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ibn Rod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
Right. Bro, you a genius. I ain't gonna lie. This is like, bro, you was a genius. I swear. This, you're gonna go down like a Elijah Muhammad or a Malcolm X with this one. You finna go down in history with this one. I swear to God, bro.
Well, I'm their child. You know, we all their children.
Yeah, but bro, you know, your own, you different, yeah, bro. I mean, to think of that. I mean, bro, this is genius. Like, I don't just say stuff just to be saying it. Like, I swear to God, bro, you are really on something to come up with this. I don't know how you came up with this, but this is,
well,
how did you come up with that?
The Mississippi campaign represents everything that you claim that you want. The beginning of an all-black independent nation. The ability to control your own resources. Your politics. The law. Be able to do your own thing for a change. Create an economy. Create and produce goods that Africa or anybody on the planet would want. You're fake, you don't want to do nothing. 3 hours talking about the Mississippi campaign.
It's your clothing. Just keep me going.
Let's see, Talik says, can you send a shout out to my platform, The Realities Temple on...
On Earth Internet Ministry. Our theme this year is After Purge Comes the Heal. So shout out to your platform, Talik. All the best to you guys with continuing to stretch in perspective, to stretch in what is possible, and to continue to bring healing into the space of yourself and others. Yes.
Just keep it going.
Realize that God has been imprisoned. The devil was able to imprison God. So right inside your own self, your God self has been imprisoned, and you have a false sense of self running rampant inside the temple. This is why, you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
We have to bring reality's temple here on earth. Reality's temple here on earth.
Yes, sir.
We have to realize the enemy is running rampant inside this temple.
And that is Brother Talik from the Reality Temples on Earth channel. And if you get a chance to subscribe, please do subscribe to his channel. He's a good brother. You know, he's doing good work, and he wants to do good constructive things. He has good information to provide. So please do check out his channel if you get a chance.
My brother Angel Snubnub 7 at the Reality Temple. And to give props to him, because I listened to all of Angel Snubnub 7's videos, I think that he comes from a different angle. And there's a powerful message in a lot of the videos that he put out, and I try to catch all of them. I look at him as a free thinker and a person that's willing to challenge those of which he don't agree with or which he may think differently from. And I really respect him for that. He's challenged KMBS, and he has also challenged the Black Supremacy movement as well. And I have nothing against that, because that which cannot be challenged cannot stand and will not stand and will not survive the test of time. How many challenges we can withstand will determine how long we will be able to stand.
Hey, bro, this is genius. Like, I don't just say stuff just to be saying it. Like, I swear to God, bro, you are really on something to come up with this. I don't know how you came up with this, but this is...
Well,
how did you come up with that?
Throughout the history of the United States, the construct of racism was created specifically to oppress Black people, to try to suppress our determination to achieve liberation. Like Angela Davis said, it's built into the system.
Nowadays I can't believe what's going on in front of me. I don't want to watch TV and find another casualty. I don't want to read the news. My heart's already black and blue. I'm putting on my combat boots, cause I got an attitude. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. Don't you even ask me, when did I become such an angry Black woman? In the air, we keep praying for a miracle, cause every day is a struggle. But as long as my brothers and my sisters are in trouble, goddamn, I'm a ABW.
We can't successfully put an end to racial discrimination until we change the entire system.
We've been trying to keep the peace, 50 years since Martin King. Some don't like me for who I am, but I love my melanin. Another future college grad, sleeping in a body bag. Mother screaming out her lungs, she never gonna see her son. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. And don't you even ask me, when did I become such an angry black woman? But as long as my brothers and my sisters are in trouble, you're damn right, I'm a ABW. Soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. So don't you even ask me, when did I become such an angry black woman?
Brothers and sisters, this is Tangi Cox, the Black Sheep, and I am propositioning you to entertain just a little while of being in reality. And this is going to hurt soul sisters and brothers, because a lot of us cannot accept reality. I empower you to, for 1 year, to subscribe to the Reality Temple on Earth. And at the end of 12 months, draw your conclusion of what have you learned in that amount of time. I empower you. You will never, ever, ever think, feel, or entertain nonsense ever again, period. I would like to see my soul sisters and brothers awaken. This requires time. You need to spend about a year watching, researching, and looking. Reality Temple on Earth is life-changing, and I stand on that.
Let's get this party started quickly.
Game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Peace forever and always, and welcome to another spontaneous broadcast of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I am the gatekeeper or the host of this program, known here on social media, wherever you may find me. I am known as the mighty, mighty, mighty Angel Snub Number 7. I am your soul brother, number one. As we dwell, as we entertain ourselves with this topic, I want you to keep in mind something I was taught in the Nation of Islam from the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. He taught a good name is better than gold. Let me repeat that. A good name is better than gold. I want you to keep this in mind as we get into our topic of, is this what we call a black legacy? In reality, is it white? Come on, brother. You always talking some bull doo-doo. How can a black legacy be white? Well, I could be wrong. I'm probably the only one on YouTube that actually expresses I could be in error. I could be wrong. If you can show me that and it passes the criteria of logic and reason, common sense, being analytical, I will have to accept what you bring to me because I want to be as correct as possible, regardless to what I like, regardless to what makes me feel good, regardless to what I believe, because if you are truly a truth seeker, it's not about my belief. It's about knowing. And sometimes knowing or the truth hurts us because we believe we already know. That's why many persons on social media and out in the real community, you can't tell them nothing because I already know. So it's their job to convince you that what they know is correct. And they get angry and they get upset because, look, I know. How dare you reject what I say? Because I know. I've been here on social media since 2007. I don't get angry with nobody because they don't agree with me because I know so much. I have the truth. Because you have a right to believe whatever you wish to believe. However, if you tell me that what I'm saying is incorrect, I would defend this because I'm telling you what I know is better than what you believe. This platform stands upon what I know, not what I believe. I could care less about my belief. I don't want to hear my belief. I want to know. I want facts. I want reality as much as possible. So it's not about what I know. I could care less about what I know. I mean, what I believe. I could tell you what I believe. So what? And through the years, I found out what I believe is not true. It hurts. It makes you upset. It makes you
frustrated and makes you feel like a fool. Because some of these things that we claim we know, we believe in these things for years. And some of you will die on what you believe, not on what you know. Your belief, you'll take it to the grave, because in reality, you're not a truth seeker. Truth has been hidden from us. Being able to think for ourselves, we have been denied all over the earth, humanity, for thousands of years. So now we are little by little coming into an awakening where we can think for ourselves. I don't need no holy book. I don't need no holy man. I don't need nobody special and divine. Because wherever they got their wisdom from, if it's from the divine, then I'm connected to the divine too. What make you think you're special and better than me when we all come from the same source? You're not better than me. Don't allow nobody to tell you that they are better than you, more divine, more connected to the God, more connected to the heavens, more connected to the wisdom than you are. We all come from the same source. What make you think that you better? And then we bow down to them and give them our money. They're so special or whatever. If you care for me, why are you charging me for your so-called wisdom? Why you want me to put your ugly ass face on my wall? Why you want me to bow down and praise you? These are deceivers. I've never asked nobody to put my ugly ass face on their wall or call me some divine or praise me in some kind of way. I'm just a brother in the struggle. We all come from the same place. And we all claim we want to get out of this hell. And we combine our knowledge. We combine our resources so that we can get up out of hell. How the hell are you better than me and you trapped in hell just like I am? But you better, you greater, you smarter. And you're going to go to the grave and rot. And the maggots eat your flesh, and you're going to decompose into nothing, but you better than me. The universe don't give a damn about us. The fly don't give a damn about you. The wildebeest don't give a damn. The giraffe, the elephants don't give a damn about you. Life comes, life goes. You think you special because thousands of people listen to your ragged ass mouth. How beautiful you are. Beauty fades. Things die. So what? The universe don't give a damn about you. You come and you go. Get caught up in the praise of people. And those people can't save you from the grave. Rich, poor, black, white, young, old. When death comes to knocking, there's nothing you can do about it. Prince, Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston sold millions of records known all over the earth. So what? In the grand scheme of things, what did it? So what? And then after you die, the vultures come in to get what you left. And you could have did better on the earth because you had more riches than you would ever be able to use You could have actually helped somebody that's alive on the planet. But I got to live. I got to have 400 swimming pools. I got to have 400 cars. I got to have all this. And you die, none of it go with you. But this is the atmosphere. This is the environment that we live in. When you're dead, nobody don't give a damn. It's over. There's no more Prince records. There's no more Whitney Houston records. There's no more Elijah Muhammad lectures. When you're gone, it's over. And you will be remembered so somebody can use you after you die. Because there's nothing that you can do that can stop them. The vultures start flying in. We should be concentrated on our living self and showing the value of life. I am not saying that we should not want adoration, admiration, somebody to admire us for our talents and the things that we bring. But when we believe our own hype, and we get to the point where we think that we are better. Go to the graveyard. There was a lot of better folks. The last 2 weeks, I spent in the graveyard. I don't know who these people was, but I'm very sure a lot of them saw themselves as being better. And you see where they at. So what? Ain't nobody dead better than the living. Ain't nobody that was in that cemetery was better than me. I'm stepping over the graves. And one day they will step over me. But I'm better. You better. There are those who call people, I know in the Nation of Islam, they like to call people the lost found because you're ignorant. See, they are found. You're lost. But they're in the same cemetery with you and me. How the hell are you found and you in the cemetery with me? But you better. You have the supreme knowledge, but the supreme knowledge, you still in the cemetery with me. You still in the cesspool with me. But you better. And you've been talking this garbage for 100 years almost. With your supreme wisdom. All these folks. I'm awakened. I'm black conscious. I'm better than the average Negro in the streets. But you still in the cesspool. You still in the streets. You still in the cemetery with them. But you conscious. Conscious only means that you are aware. I'm conscious. Conscious does not mean that you will take action and move upon your awakening. It just means that you're conscious. I'm awake. When the alarm clock goes off, you become conscious of the time. But that does not mean that you're going to move because the alarm clock went off. It just means, okay, I know what time it is. So there's many people that know what time it is. But that does not mean that you're going to get up and do anything. You lay your ass right there and time continues to move. Next thing you know, you late for work. But you conscious of the time. But you didn't move. You didn't do nothing. You are in a fire. And you conscious of the fire. But you just lay in bed. You don't try to escape, but you conscious. Oh, wow, there's a fire going. I see the smoke. I see everything. But you just lay there. So what? Because you conscious. You are awake, But if you don't do nothing, so what? To escape the fire, not only must you be conscious, not only must you be awake, you have to have a proper plan to escape the fire, otherwise you burn up. This is why, with all this consciousness, you're still in the fire burning up. With all this consciousness, this black man and woman of America, soul brothers and sisters, Foundation of Black Americans, whatever you want to call yourself this week, you can't even make up your mind who the hell or what you are. You can't even identify with nothing. Confused. Whatever you are this week, you have to have a escape plan to get out of the fire. That's why you're still in the cemetery. So I wouldn't go around bragging, I'm awake, I'm conscious. And then we use these titles, I'm a god, I'm a goddess. No! You ain't none of those things. You're not a king, you're not a queen. You're a feral slave on a plantation. That is why we as a people have not made no progress. We've added nothing to the gains of the civil rights movement. That's why, woo, that's why you keep talking about the past. Because you're not doing nothing now. And since you're not doing nothing now, clearly you're not going to do nothing in the future. So you keep talking about Kemet, the ancient Israelites, and blah, blah. You don't even have nothing to do with those things. You talk about civil rights. Many of us, we did not contribute to the civil rights movement either. We keep talking about what they did in Black Wall Street. You wasn't there. You wasn't part of no march in Alabama or Mississippi, or you didn't carry a gun with the Black Panther Party. You didn't do nothing. You keep talking about what we did. What you mean what we done? You wasn't there. You didn't do nothing. But you conscious, you awake, because you ate some grapefruit. Because you drank some green juice this morning. So what? Because I'm conscious, I'm awake. So what? You only impress other misfits. Other people that's in the miserable condition, that ain't done a damn thing, not gonna do a damn thing, so you can feel good. Your legacy, what kind of legacy? My legacy, these men, I wanna have these children, my legacy. You keep talking about generational wealth, my legacy, generational wealth. What you gonna leave? Because when it's all said and done, you can't take it to the grave. What is this legacy? That's what I want to do. We want to examine the legacy. I know the fake, false, fairy tale, la-di-da, feel-good legacy that you talk about. I know what you into. We gonna look at this legacy realistically, what it is for real. Our legacy, my bloodline. Nature don't give a damn about your bloodline. That's vanity. Nature only cares about the survival of a species. Don't give a damn about your personal legacy. These nursing homes is a $1 billion business. These children aren't taking care of their parents or whoever in these nursing homes. Your legacy put your ass in a nursing home. And you're going to be happy to get there. They're going to put your sick ass in a nursing home with your legacy self, my legacy, your legacy children. And many of these children gonna take what you left and go gamble and squander and all that. That's the reality of it. They don't give a damn about generational wealth. They don't give a damn about your legacy. They're gonna do exactly what you done is enjoy your life, because you don't give a damn about the struggle of a slave, the suffering of our ancestors on a slave plantation, our suffering of our people that were sharecroppers for over 100 years. You don't give a damn. So why should your children give a damn? They didn't even have to work for it. You gave it to them so they could squander. I'm going to say it's for my children. And many of you will be alive and you will know your legacy, what your legacy has done with your generational wealth. Nobody left me nothing because they couldn't leave me nothing. And I've seen people where grandparents or whoever left their legacy all kinds of farmland and property. And it's all gone. They done squandered it. Duh. See, brother, you got to teach the people. I don't give a damn what you say to people. I don't give a damn what you teach. You dead and gone. I don't care what you teach folks. You have people that grew up, that was born in the church. Prostitutes, drug dealers, drug addicts, and they grew up in the church. So what? I taught them. The only thing they know is Jesus Christ. The only thing they know is Allah. The only thing they know is Yahshua Yeshua. I'm a child of Israel. They was born in it and still in prison for murder. Still a prostitute. Still going to the strip club. What I teach, nobody don't give a damn about your teaching. This individual stuff that we do don't mean a damn thing. We have to clean up the environment itself. There's an old African proverb. It takes a village to raise a child. Because the village is the environment. There was a time in the black community where all the people was a parent, even the drunk in the street. Because I know people that was drunk in the street. Hey, son, you know you shouldn't be doing that. So you was outside of your biological parent, but even when you went outside, there was other adults that would check you. Oh, hey, no, you can't put that down, son. Don't do that, boy. Hey, girl, now you know better. I'm going to go tell your mama. It takes a village. It takes an environment to raise a child. I don't care who you think you are, how smart, educated. Because this environment that we live in is foul. So you grew up in the Nation of Islam. You grew up in the church. I don't care how these children grew up. They still end up in prison. Crackheads. Because it takes a village. We, as the men, this is why I'm so hard on the male, because the man's supposed to be the provider and the protector, and you have not, we have not as men created the environment, the proper nest to raise our babies, our children now, and protect our woman, our females. We have failed them and don't want to hear it. You want accolades, you want praise for doing nothing because you got a penis, because you can talk bad. But look at the environment. Your children going to hell. What kind of man are you? And you see your sisters on the street, they selling their body. Oh, that's their choice. Because you're too damn weak to do anything about it. That's why it's their choice. She should feel protected. You the man. We supposed to be the men. And we have yet to protect our women. Slavery was an excuse a few days ago. You're supposed to be free. And your daughter on the corner selling her backside on a stripper pole. It takes a village. All the men, we're not going to tolerate it no more as men. I said years ago, the men in Chicago, and they did try in Detroit, but you got a bunch of cowards that wouldn't help, wouldn't join. The brothers in Detroit got together. We ain't tolerating this no more. And one brother, I believe, in Detroit was killed. We gonna take on the gang members. The buck stops here because the men not gonna tolerate this foolishness. But there are no men. Just a penis in men's clothing. There are no men. And they get angry at me how I talk. I don't give a damn. You can get upset all you want to. I'm not going to give you credit unless you earn it. Bunch of punks, sissies. You can huff and puff all you want to. And while you huffing and puffing, your grandmother cannot even, she cannot even sit on her porch. Idiots drive-by shooting, dumbass stuff like that, because grandma don't have no men. There's no men in the community. The police is nice, but we gonna deal with this. And after we done with your ass, we might give you to the police. Find your ass floating down the river somewhere. Put you on the missing persons list. That's what men gonna do. Because you're not gonna shoot my son. You're not gonna shoot my father. The village of men, not gonna allow that. My legacy. What kind of legacy you got right now? Cowards. Losers. Booty hungry men. You will fight to get into a club to watch a woman drop her panties like you ain't never seen a naked woman before. Even young boys have seen naked women. And you go all crazy. Look at her booty. I remember that's what we used to do when we was little boy. She's showing her booty. She's showing her, that's nasty, That's what we did when we was little boys. Here you are, grown ass man. You go to the strip club, I'm gonna make it rain. Like you ain't never seen booty and breasts before. Pitiful ass men on YouTube crying and whimpering. The most pitiful, pathetic, loser men I ever been around in my life. Crying and whimpering, emotional. Talk about, oh, women are emotional. I've never been around men so emotional like these cats. They cry and whimper over anything. Because they still boys. And they never been in it. They never been in an environment of strong men. Your legacy. Legacy of cowards, weak, pathetic, losers. Living off dead folks. Dr. King is not here. And they talk about it. Dr. King and Malcolm. Living off dead folks because your pathetic, pitiful ass can't do nothing. You're a boy. You need your mama. Grab her hand so that you can go across the street. That's not my fault. You talking all this hocus pocus. I'm a man garbage. And you sisters, you feed the weakness. Because when they come up with excuses not to be a fool, because you understand your nature tell you, and you are attracted to a strong man, but you make excuses for them. A lot of you, because you don't want to see your man hurt. This Caucasian woman in America during the Revolutionary War, you think they didn't want to see, you think they wanted their husbands to die? They wanted their husbands and their sons to be hurt? But that's what men do. These men in America, George Washington the boy, told England, go to hell. I'm not your damn slave. So mama, come over here. I'm gonna put you in check. Come on with it. They didn't have a well-trained army. They didn't have no special uniforms. But I'm not gonna let you punk me. I'm not gonna let you make me your B word. And when you tell black men here about real fighting, it's got to be a better way. They come up with all these excuses, even the tough ones. They come up with all these excuses. There should be no gangs causing hell in your community. But you have no men. Look. You just tell them, look, a little scrappy or Mo-D or whatever you want to call yourself. We can't have this no more, brothers. Brothers, and some of you even know these gang members and people. They your sons, they your daughters. You have to tell them, we ain't doing this no more. I don't know where you're doing it, but you gotta do it. You gotta do it somewhere else. That's what men do. And if some of us have to die, so be it. But I guarantee you, the good brothers outnumber them 100-1. Smash your ass. Don't have to worry about them. I'm not calling no police. The men will handle it. The men will handle. Ain't no Peckerwoods coming in our community and shoot our people down. We're not going to tolerate it. And I can guarantee you, they won't be coming to your neighborhood and killing you. Because the men, we're not tolerating that. But we have no men. Bunch of beggars. What kind of legacy? And it goes back to your name. Because your name don't reflect nothing. Your name is weak. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught, a good name is better than gold. What kind of legacy is this black man leaving? In order for people to actually have a legacy, you must develop culture. But a slave or people under the rule of another cannot develop culture. You can only have subculture. That means you are under somebody else. African American culture is subculture. That's why they say black history is American history. Because you belong and you are under somebody else. And you accept that. A subculture is like when you go to prison. Prison culture is subculture because it's still American culture, except it's something that's developed within prison walls, but it's still American culture. the slave developed their own culture out of slavery, but it's still under America because it's founded. It's not self-discovery. It's something that's founded within the confines of America. No matter how you spell it, I know some of you, you want to spell America, A-M-E-R-I-K-K-K-A, whatever, to make yourself like you're a revolutionary. But you ain't shot one damn bullet. You ain't suffered not one time in jail. Many of you have the nerve to make mockery of Dr. King and those who were in the nonviolent movement, and you ain't did a damn thing. You ain't done nothing. You ain't suffered. You ain't sacrificed. You living off the back of Dr. King and those who were practicing nonviolent protest, you piece of trash. I'm guilty. See, I'm not talking, I'm guilty myself. Because I was brainwashed to make mockery of nonviolent protest. So I'm, but at the same time, I didn't do nothing violent. And then when I wanted to do something violent, the ones around me, oh, don't do that. Stop it. We'll get in trouble. What? So if you are against nonviolent protest, that means you are violent. What have you done violent? Absolutely nothing. Except smoke some damn weed. You was so happy when they legalized weed. A lot of these pro-black folks, they now you happily smoking your weed, your fake ass. That's why they don't like Angel Snuffin' Up 7. Because I know what you are for real. If you was real revolutionary with all the thousand people talking all this garbage, we should have added on, we should progress and done something within the last 50 years. These pieces of trash have not done nothing. But they awake and they're conscious. You are awake to do what? The legacy, my legacy. A slave don't have no damn legacy. A slave don't have no culture. Except what their master allow them to do. A prisoner don't have nothing except what the prison allow them to do. Because you are under somebody else, my legacy. A slave, look it up in the dictionary. An oppressed person, a confined person, a slave cannot develop culture. You are under the rule of somebody else. It becomes subculture under somebody else. The one kicking you in your ass, or the one who has incarcerated you, or the one who's oppressing you day in and day out. So you develop something to live comfortable with what they give you within the confines of the culture that you were born in, you was raised in, within the confines of another man. Your legacy. What kind of legacy? We're going to talk about this. Like I said, I could be wrong. Join the conversation. Show me how I'm incorrect. All these fairy tale, feel good, la-di-da, I don't want to hear that stuff. Because when you tell me, show me the actions. There are no actions. There's no benefits. Even that, what's that fella? Charleston White. Even he said, we've done nothing for the last 50 years. We've done nothing. And they were talking about the Million Man March. What did the Million Man March do? Here you are still complaining. So what did the Million Man March do? It didn't do anything. crashed in 1968 or whatever, 1963. Been there, done that. You're doing the same things that people done back in the, this is your time. Are you an idiot? You don't have no brain. You can't come up with a strategy. You can't come up with something on your own. You gotta go to dead folks. You're a grave robber. There's nothing awakened. There's nothing alive about you. You're nothing but walking zombies. That's why you don't understand Angel Stump Number 7, because I'm thinking like a free people. Your legacy. We need generational wealth. As an individual or certain groups. You may not know this, but we have already done it. There are many individuals who already have obtained generational wealth. There's even a group of people, and I saw a documentary. There's a group of black people, black Americans, that don't want nothing to do with you. They are not on the internet. They're not talking some stuff. There's a bougie class of black people in this country. They don't mix with us. You don't hear about them. They have generational wealth and they keep it all to themselves. And they marry and mix only with within those within that circle who have created this generational wealth. And you call them the bougie. You don't know nothing about them. We don't even know who they are. They don't make themselves known. They've already done it. They have generational wealth. And they built this so-called legacy for themselves. And they want nothing to do. You will never see them associate with Umar Johnson. They don't associate with Farrakhan. They stay within their circle. You can probably go look it up. They want nothing to do with us. They already done that. So, what has this done for us as a people? You as an individual with your generational wealth, your little funky family, your little funky group, that do not help us as a people. Individuals looking out for your bloodline, for your family, which some of them are going to squander your money anyway. There's nothing you can do about it. You're going to be in the grave. I know you had the great intentions, but that's life. I've seen it in my lifetime. I've seen people, their grandparents and great-grandparents left them a certain amount of money and property. Don't have none of it. The children, the people squandered it. So wisdom dictates that we as a people, if you are wise, it is important to develop generational wealth as a people, not as individuals. Because if you do it as individuals, when you die, it's over. You don't know your children, your legacy might do right by you and they might not do right by you. I'm going to tell you, the majority of the time, they don't. They take your crap because they didn't have to work. They didn't earn nothing. They take your crap and blow it. The same thing they would do if the government decided to give individual reparations. Just like when they win the lottery. When these folks win the lottery or they win these big lawsuits, what do they do for the black community? They leave. I'm going to go to Africa. I'm going to do something. They don't give a damn about black community. They don't give a damn about black folks. It's about them. So if generational wealth is not about the people themselves, generate and maintain generational wealth, it don't mean nothing. You still gonna be in the hole because you putting it all in the hands of silly individuals or a silly group. You have silly group. Like I said, there's a class of black folks in this country, you call them bougie, or the bougie class, has nothing to do with E.B. Du Bois or whatever those people. They was active. They not even part of it. They don't give a damn about us, the average black person in this country. And their wealth, who knows what kind of changes, what kind of help they could give to us. They only care about my own, taking care of my legacy. So a legacy should be determined and based upon what a people, a group, what we leave. Generational wealth should be formed and maintained by the people themselves. Because we already got generational wealth. We already got individuals with their legacy and their generational wealth. Don't help us. It don't help 40 million. In this country. And when it's all said and done, excuse the language. And when it's all said and done, you still a nigga with a legacy. You still a nigga with generational wealth. And people like Oprah Winfrey and Will Smith and whoever these people are, Bob Johnson, they always get their wake-up calls all the time because they run into somebody that tell them who they really are. You a nigga, because as long as the people, I was told no person can rise above the people they come from. So Oprah is a nigga. LeBron is a nigga. Jada Pinkett Smith is a nigga. You can't rise above. So generational wealth, if only one or two individuals got it, you still a nigga. A rich nigga, a nigga with a legacy, a nigga with generational wealth, you still nothing. That's why the bougie class, that's why they keep their ass hiding in secret. Why don't you come out from hiding? Why don't you show yourself? Because they niggas. And they know it. They know all the money they have, all the generation of what they have, all the stuff that don't mean nothing. You trying to compete with a people that have a 400-year head start, who still have advantages that you don't have till this day. You trying to compete with them. You don't have a nuclear power plant. You don't make electricity. You don't have a coal mine. You don't drill for gas and oil. You're trying to compete with these people. You can't compete with them. You far behind. I know there are those. They love that fantasy life. You can keep living that. But this is the reality. This is the reality's temple. Do you think that for some reason I feel good saying these things or whatever? No, I don't. But if you don't like it, change it. Because you awake, you conscious, well, change it then. This is the election year. And I even see blackity black folks vote for Kamala Harris, vote for Donald Trump, still looking for the great white hope, still looking for God, looking for the white man to save you, looking for a savior, somebody save me. But you awake and you conscious and you got the supreme wisdom and you know all this stuff. You still waiting for somebody, Mr. Man, Mr. Legacy. You still waiting for somebody to come save your crazy ass. When our ancestors came off the plantation, they were set loose. They weren't made free. They were set loose. But even so, they didn't have a lot of education in the world. They just tried to survive or whatever. But even though they lacked the supreme wisdom, because you have the supreme wisdom, you awaken, you cannot even accomplish what they was doing. And they were just set loose. How embarrassing. Yo, legacy. So our ancestors came off the slave plantation. They were set loose. Called free. But whenever you become free, there's a process that's going to happen because you're free. Because a lot of the confines that you once had, you no longer have. And there's a lot of things that you couldn't do now that you can do because you're free. So now you start developing. Because that's just the natural development when you're free. These people, these Caucasians came from England. They came from Great Britain. But when we talk about them, these are American. And those are from Britain. But there's a difference. Because when they became free of Britain, they began to develop their own culture and their own way of living life outside of Britain. They still maintain some of the things because that's where they come from. They came from England. They came from Britain. But now there's a difference between America and Britain. Fish and chips in Britain is not the same as fish and chips in America. There's a difference. Because now I'm free. Like when you leave your mama and daddy house, the way you cook chicken might be different from how mama done her chicken, how they raise you. You raise your children different. That because you free of mommy and daddy. You still love mommy and daddy. That's grandpa, that's grandma or whatever. But now I'm free of them. And you do things your way. What you didn't like about what they done, you don't have to do it. So you begin to develop your own household. So we as a people started doing the same thing. With the tools that we had, we did the best we could. One of the things which even started in slavery was our development of our own way of talking, our own type of language. There was something called Pig Latin. And then, of course, we know something called, they call it Ebonics. And then there are some of us, I heard like what's those people called? Nuwabian culture. They developed and created their own language. That's what free people do. There was a time when white folks didn't know what the hell we was talking about. There was a time in slavery where the slaves developed a language and they could talk right in front of Massa. Massa have no idea of what they're talking about. And we still do that. I listen to some of these younger people. They come up with this. You call it slang. I said that it's your language because it was developed from out of your womb, from you. And the only ones who really understand it is those in our circle. Other people got to say, what do that mean? Hell, I remember growing up, I had to ask, what the hell do that mean? I'm part of the circle, and I had to ask, what do that mean? But that's what free people do. And Ebonics didn't come from Africa. Ebonics did not come from the Holy Bible. It didn't come from the Holy Quran. It simply came from a people, all the people in the same circumstance, developed a language that this people could understand. That's yours. Free people develop things that belong to them. Out of the tools that they know, it's still English, but we created something that's us, that we understand. So-called Ebonics was so misunderstood, a black person had to wrote an encyclopedia or a book so the white folks know, what the hell are those Negroes talking about? Oh, I'll sell you this book of Ebonics, our language. Oh, that's what that means. Golly gee. We came up with our own way of even marrying ourselves, jump the broom. That's what something the slave. We make mockery of the slave, but even the slave developed something that was just for the slave. Right? We're going to jump the broom. Get married. We're going to jump the broom. We do things and adopt things that's from us. Because that is culture. Culture is based upon the tools and the environment that you in, how you respond. Soul music, the black, that's something that was to us. Our pain, our suffering, the blues, gospel music, that was only one that could get it came from. It was us. And it was developed because of our suffering. Now you have white folks and other people, they do gospel music. But see, our music came from our hurt and our pain. It wasn't entertainment. That's how we dealt with our suffering and our oppression through our song and our dance. Even till this day, we still do it. It comes from us. We make mockery of things that actually come from us. Ghetto names. What's wrong? What's a ghetto name? Some of our people, they create their own names and they define their own names. And you make mockery of it. Donald Muhammad. You have the name of an Arab, some foreigner. And all these names that you got out the Bible that you did not write. And these foreigners. How the hell you have the nerve to make fun of Shaniqua and these names that we come up with. You call them ghetto names. But see, the thing about it is, when you hear those names, you know it came from us. It did not come from Africa. It didn't come from the Bible. It came from us. That's what free people do. Because I'm free. I don't need your damn name. I can create and develop a name just like myself. And part of my legacy is my name. A good name is better than gold. This name comes from us. So when you hear that name, you know it came from my blood. It came from my people. We name ourselves all this different stuff. Then they look at you. You're not Chinese. You're not European. You don't look like no African. You carry their legacy because that's not you. You're not an African. You're not no Aboriginal. You're not none of this stuff. Now you free and you want to copy everybody because now you awaken, you getting your education, you done read all these books. You want to go back to the slave plantation. You want to copy everybody. You proud because your last name Muhammad and Kareem Abdullah and these Egyptian names and whatever. That's not you. That have nothing to do with you. Because when somebody look at the name, they looking to see somebody from Egypt, somebody from Africa, somebody from China. Here you are, you're a Negro from America. With all these crazy names. That's not your legacy. That's their stuff. And you make mockery of the things that you create. If you, woo, man. If you stay, if we was able to stay on point, we would be in a much, much better position. If you stayed on point, developing yourself as a free person. Oh, no, somebody told you it's better to be a slave. And you gravitate toward that lie that you are Muslim. That's part of, that's you. That's them Arabs. Trace that name. It don't have nothing to do with you. Trace these names from Kemet. Don't have nothing to do with you. You keeping another man alive. That's why I know you're not a man. Because a man is not going to keep another man's legacy alive. That's not yours. You don't have nothing to do with that. My legacy. You don't have no damn legacy. You're nothing but a feral slave, still a slave, still a piece of trash, bent over, getting pumped by another man with a smile on your face. And these women don't know no better. That ain't go with you. Because they don't know no damn better. Following behind a weak-ass man can only produce a weak-ass woman. That's why the women with you. Because they weak. The man is weak. And you develop these weak-ass children. No matter how, no matter what you say, they end up in prison. They end up drug addicts and whatever. Because your ass is weak, your woman is weak, children is weak, your damn dog Scruffy is weak. I know you don't like, I know they don't like it. I know they bring your ass and show me different. Join the conversation. Join the conversation. Show me different. You're not gonna be able to do that. Only thing you're gonna do is be able to talk, say some feel-good stuff. You're not gonna be able to show me anything. That's why I'm able to talk and I'm confident in what I'm saying because I know you don't have nothing to show. Fifty years after the Civil Rights Movement, this generation, we've added nothing to the gains of the Civil Rights Movement. Should be ashamed. And you're going to tell me about your legacy. A good name is better than gold. That was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught. Let's break it down simply like this. Now you will agree, we're gonna wrap this conversation up. Now you will agree, which I don't care if you agree or not. It don't make no difference. You're a weak ass man anyway. So who gives a damn? with your mouth all poked out like a little child. Some of these grown ass men. You wrong. You wrong. You a bad man. You a bad man. I wish I had a pacifier for your ass. I've never been around men. So weak. Pathetic. Losers. We're going to do this very simply. As you know, some of you who are familiar with the Roots story, we have the story of Kunta Kinte, right? His name was Kunta Kinte. And he did come from Africa. There's no doubt about it. He don't have to get an African DNA test. We know that Kunta Kinte, according to the story, was an African. He was called African. Fiddler called him African Guinea Man. He was forced. He was forced by a whip. He became Toby. Is Toby an African name? No. Okay, y'all with me? Is Toby an African name? No. How was Kunta Kinte given the name? Through violence, force. And he became Toby. Because that's what you do when you become somebody's property. Toby was the property of another man. And the other man named him Toby. You my property. Now y'all know, so many of you will agree that Toby is not Kunta Kinte's real name. It was forced upon him. But then you have those who take another man's name, and you wasn't whipped. You wasn't forced. What about you? We take all these names from the Bible, from the Quran, and these foreign folk. You do it voluntarily. A free people develop their own name. Your own language, your own culture. That's what free people do, but a slave, voluntary or involuntary, you adopt the name of a slave master. That's what a slave do. Because a slave is not free. So we know that you're not free because you got to develop and you take on names from foreigners and other slave owners. Tell me I'm wrong. You ain't gonna tell me I'm wrong. So we have our brother Michael Jackson, slave master name, Michael Jackson. His name is Michael, son of Jack. Who the hell is Jack? Mello, are you still out there? Mello, who the hell is Jack? Jackson, son of Jack. Who the hell is Jack? So, we know Michael, chances are Jack is a European. So whose legacy, and we know Michael is European, right? Michael, son of Jack. He's not even the son of Joseph. Joe Jackson, he's the son of Jack. Matter of fact, Joseph is the son of Jack. Joseph, son of Jack. Jack, look, whoever Jack is, got around. White folks is Jackson, and black folks is Jackson. That's his legacy. which probably origins in Europe some damn where. But see, if you're a Caucasian person, that's all right, because that's where they come from. That's who they are. But here you are. We know that that's not us. And we know that we're not European, but at the same time, we know that we're not these African. We never lived in no Africa. We never lived in Kemet. We didn't do that. So as a free person, then what you do, you got to start all over from scratch. I'm free. I developed my own names. I don't need Jackson. I don't need Muhammad. I don't need Solale, Wele, these African, whatever these names that we come up with. That's not you. I'm free. I develop and create my own name. What is wrong with you? Don't you have a brain? You talk about God. Aren't you connected to the universe? Aren't you connected to God just like they are? See, but you and I are in a position where now we can not only develop our own culture, our own history, we can protect it as time goes on. So our children don't need no African DNA. They don't need none of that stuff. Because from now, from this point, we protect our history. We don't need Caucasian people to keep up with our history. We don't need no Africans to keep up with us. We do our own thing. So 100, 2,000 years from now, our people, whatever we decide to call ourselves, they will know, because we protected this. This is ours. And when you bring it, the world will know, oh, that came from them. When you talk about soul brothers and sisters, woo! When you talk about soul brothers and sisters, there's only one people that has that identity. When you say soul brothers and sisters, you don't see an African. When you say soul brothers and sisters, you don't see nobody from China. Or even from the islands. It's us. What's wrong with you embracing yourself, your own creativity, your own uniqueness? What's wrong with that? I'm not a foundational Black American. Because I'm more than black skin. And I'm more than an American. And I don't want to be associated with slavery. I'm free. I don't want to found nothing in America. I'm free. Free people develop their own. Slaves got to copy and regurgitate. That's what slaves do. Because you belong to your slave master. Then you have the nerve to tell your slave master what an American is, what a Muslim is, what a Christian is. And the master taught you all that stuff. Our free people grow and develop on self-discovery. See, we don't need God unless we personally discover God. The reason why you have to adopt other people's God, because God don't exist, is a damn lie. If God existed, God would come to us just like God came to the Europeans, God came to the Arabs, God came to the Africans, and the Chinese, whoever. You have to adopt their gods. God should come to us. But God don't come to us, because God don't exist. Where was God 300 years on the slave plantation? Where was God during Jim Crow? Where is God now? Where was God when that sister was having problems with that pink woman and the pink woman shot her through the door? Where was God at? Where was God? Where was Jesus when Sonya Massey, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus, and it's almost as soon as she said that Peckerwood shot in the head. Come on, where's damn God? I'm tired of the nonsense. Don't bring me that foolishness. I'm tired of trying to be nice with y'all silly, childish, immature, slave, feral ass. Because you're not men and women. Children. And you even call yourself a child. I'm a child of the Most High. You said it. I didn't. You said I'm a child of God. Child of the Most High. And you are high. Drug addict ass. Little babies, little children. That's why you don't understand Angel Snubbing Up 7. Because I'm free. I'm a grown man. And I don't have to tell you. My actions demonstrate who I am. I don't have to carry no sign. Here I am fighting the state of Missouri by myself. Those people respected me. I don't have a gun. I don't have a knife. What did they respect? They respect my resilience. I stood up, kill me. I'm not going to bow down to you. They respected the intelligence. And once I got proper knowledge, it was over for them. I used their law to get what I wanted. I used them to get what I wanted. This is what free people do. I don't give a damn about Kamala Harris. I don't give a damn about Donald Trump. Use anybody to get what you want. Just like they use us for the last 400, almost 500 years. They use us to get what they want. It's stupid. Omar Johnson talk about he don't want no money from them. They get our money every damn day. But you don't want no money from them. That's stupid as hell. I would take their money. That's dumb. They take your money every day. You pay for the internet. You pay because we don't have an internet company. We don't have a gas company. You giving them your money every day, but you don't take no money from them. Are you crazy as hell? That's stupid. And you wonder why you don't have a school. Well, first of all, there's mismanagement. Don't know what the hell you're doing. If you think, if Bill Gates came to me and told me I will grant you $1 billion for your Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign, you think I'm not going to take it? And I will show you what should have been done 50 years ago. It's not your fault. We didn't know. We don't know. We didn't know 50 years ago. We don't know. But the time is now. But we don't need Bill Gates. We have the money. We have the talent. We have the education. We have everything that we need. We don't need them. But if Bill Gates came to me and wanted to grant me $1 billion for the Mississippi campaign, oh, hell yeah, it's on and popping. Yeah, I'll take that money. And you talk about legacy and generational wealth? The only plan, the only vision that I ever seen that will give us what we really need is this plan, this proposal, this vision that we call Operation Exodus Mississippi Campaign. Nothing else come close. You want to challenge? You want to debate the issue? Bring your happy ass on right now. We are simulcasting right now. This is Reality's Temple on Earth Internet Ministry YouTube channel. We are simulcasting on Angel Snubbing Up 7 YouTube channel and also our Reality's Temple on Earth Internet Ministry Facebook and all the affiliates, including some of you might be familiar with our Black Power Center with over 12,000 followers there, our Black Power Information Center Facebook page. Some of these pages belong to me and you don't even know. You don't even know. And actually, I'm starting to get more views on Facebook than on YouTube. But it don't make no difference. Views don't mean nothing if you're not, only thing you're going to do is view and you don't take action upon what you hear. But you are awake and you are conscious in the fire, but you're not going to get up out of the fire. So it don't mean nothing. A good name is better than gold. We're going to say this and get out of here. If you name something orange, you don't expect to see black or yellow or red. You expect something that's orange. If something is affiliated with a dog, you expect dog characteristics or actual dog or something with a dog, whatever. Like Snoop Doggy Dog. That's a man. But we understand that's just a rap name, whatever. But Snoop Doggy Dog, you, if that was a label or identity, you expect a dog or something. I tell you what I did, and I was a child. I was developing my own words and definitions for certain things. Like weather. W-E-V-A. Weather. What's a weather? That was my name for baby. That's a baby. Weather. Oh, she having a weather, a little weather. That's a baby. And the only one who would understand that would be people in my family because they heard me use it all the time. And, oh, she having a weather. Angel Snup Nup. Snup Nup was my name I created for dog. Angel Snup Nup. Angel was my dog's name. Snup Nup, Angel the dog. And I was a child developing my own definition, my own, creating my own labels for things. Angel the dog, a Snup Nup. And people in the family, my biological family is close, they know what a Snup Nup is. A Snup Nup is a dog, Angel the dog. They know what a weather is. And I was a child making up my own. But here we are as a people. So-called wise, so-called free, and you can't develop nothing. The only thing you do is sit back and copy folks. Even the bougie class, who they trying to live like? The white folks. Be like the white people, be like the oppressor, be like the slave master. But you free. Who is Oprah Winfrey trying to live like? The white folks. The pedophile R. Kelly, who he copying? The white folks. That's their history. Even a slave, we didn't do that. If you go back to slavery, all this freakish behavior, even being drunk, all this being a crackhead and transgender, we didn't do that even in slavery. There was no lesbian slave. There was no transgender slave. There was no crack addict slave. We wasn't confused in slavery. We only became freaks when we began to integrate with them because they freaks. But we didn't know it. We thought Massa was holy and righteous. We didn't know how freakish Massa really was. And they kept that a secret. But when we began to integrate with them, We started learning their secrets and we became freaks. So Houdini in 1986, Houdini came out with a song, "The Freaks Come Out at Night." What? "The Freaks Come Out at Night." What you say? "Freaks come out, the freaks come out, the freaks come out at night." There was a time in the soul community, black community, the things that we do now, just 50 years ago, we were considered nasty and vulgar. I remember my mother and her friends, they went to see a porn flick. These porn flicks start coming out in the early 1970s, I believe. And my mother and her friends would come back and talk about it. "Ooh, those people are so disgusting and nasty." And black men, they wanted to be freaks. They saw what that white woman was doing in the porn. I want to try that. But see, if we had stayed among ourselves, that wouldn't have happened. Because we didn't do that. Because our people was Christians. The majority of us, we was influenced by Christianity. And we dead set against filth like that. But once we start integrating, we became freakish like them. And now there's no shame. We just as freakish, gender confused, nasty. Just like they are. Woo! And we crazy. We adopt their religion and their the things that these people do or whatever. We just as crazy and wacky and freakish just like them. Because we came off the plantation being free, but somewhere in the mix, we went right back to the slave plantation voluntarily. Not like Kunta Kinte, because if Kunta Kinte got the chance to be free, he would have went right back to Africa, went back to his African ways. You came off the plantation and you became a freak. Some of y'all can't talk without profanity, because you're filthy and you're vulgar and you're nasty, just like these people. They taught you that. They're your example. So when you talk about my legacy, when you talk about generational wealth, you want to be like them. That's the only reason why you want it, because you want to be like your massa. But if you really was free, you'd be concentrating on, "I want a different way of life, because that way of life has demeaned me as a human being. That way of life has stalled me as a human being, my own development. Look how these suckers, look how they handle problems. They handle their problem with violence. What is it now? 40,000 Palestinians dead? For what? It has nothing to do with me being pro-Palestinian, nothing. I'm wondering why do 40,000 people need to be killed? Because these silly ass people, they a bunch of freaks and they childish and you following behind them. And that's why when some of you get angry, you do the same thing. "I want Angel Snuffing Up 7 dead." Of course, as you know, I was threatened by a religious fanatic, and this is my last month on earth, y'all. So it's good that I come out here and talk to us, because according to this religious fanatic, the month of August, I'm dead. Now, mind you, I don't give a damn. That don't scare me. They threatened my life for 10 years, locked up in the state of Missouri. So what? And then, what, 2-3 years ago, this big fat chick, Aaliyah Porkchop Muhammad, said, "I'm going to be dead." But the thing about it, I don't care. I was diagnosed with cancer in 2020. I should be dead. But see, I don't give a damn. What was it? I believe it was Dr. King. I've heard this saying. It's a saying. It's not how long you live, but how well you live your life. So I don't give a damn. As long as I know how I have lived to the best of my ability, and to bring what I have learned, my experience in this life as an older person, bring a message so maybe I can help somebody younger so they can go beyond, I'm awake, I'm black conscious. No, you need to live. You need to understand what it means to be free. Because being awake in a fire, being conscious in a fire, does not mean nothing unless you get your ass up out of bed and escape the fire. You're still in the burning house that Dr. King talked about. And these people talk about, see, Dr. King said he led his people to a burning house. Yeah. And your ass still in it, Mr. Awaken, Mr. Black, Mr. and Mrs. Black Conscious. You're still in the damn house. So what's your problem? Because you're not free. You're not acting like a free people. You don't have a free mind. You can't move. You can't progress because you're depending on somebody else, on a new slave master to help you. Some foreigner, their gods, Kamala Harris, Donald Trump, whoever, you looking for a slave master. Please, sir, somebody help us, sir. Because you're a child. And you're a freak. If I said something about a penis or a vagina, the people's eyes are light up. What are you going? Because you're a damn freak. He said vagina. He said you get all lit up. You are an adult. You never seen a penis before. You never seen a vagina before. You're still tripping up your body parts. Children. There's primitive people. The women walk around butt naked all day long. I don't see none of the men. Woo, hey man, look at them, look at them breasts. Look at that booty. Woo! These are primitive people. And the women walk around naked. Men walk around and butt naked. They ain't tripping off of it. But here you are. And here you are. I gotta have sex 40 times a day. Those are primitive people. They ain't tripping off stuff like that. You know what they tripping on? Survival. See, you a comfortable ass slave. And don't have nothing else better to do. That's why you can trip on foolishness like these children. When you a child and mommy and daddy pay all the damn bills, you get caught up in foolishness. Because you know the white man got your back with your awakened conscious ass. That's why you don't need Angel Snuff Number 7. Because you know the white man got your back. Oh, I don't need your help, Snuff Nup. I don't need to unite with nobody. Because you know, Massa, you know the white folks got your back. You comfortable in the cemetery. You comfortable in the cesspool with your awakened, black conscious, pan-African, black Muslim, whatever the hell you want to call your dumb ass. A good name is better than gold. So you don't expect to see red, black, or yellow if something is called orange. Here we are, the ones called color, the ones called Negro in this country, and we adopted these names and these labels, and they see us. When did you come from Egypt? When did you come from Africa? When did you come from China? Well, all these When was you an Israelite? When was you a Moor? We adopt all these different names. Misidentification. It's like if you go to the store and somebody put corn on the label, but really it's peas inside the can. And that's what we are, mislabeled. Because we are not a free people. We need a slave master. I want the Moors to be my slave master. I don't like white folks. I want the Moors to be my slave, who don't exist. Who don't exist. They can't, ain't no Moor can guide you anywhere. They don't exist. The Israelites don't exist. They can't guide you nowhere. The people that we follow, most of them don't even exist. They're gone. Trying to follow Malcolm X. He is not here no more. Elijah Muhammad is not here no more. We're grave robbers and we're obsessed with dead folk. It's like a child when your parents die. Mommy, daddy, what do you do when you're orphan and your parents die? And you don't know your family. I'm gonna say this, we need to get out of here. You need to understand this. You start all over again. You meet somebody, the child meets somebody, marries them, start their own family, and now it starts all over again. Brand new. And that's what the God in the Bible teaches. You don't even believe, because the scriptures say that this God will create a new heaven and a new earth, and the former things shall pass away. You can't let go of the former things. And what makes it so bad, they're not you. I don't have no problem letting all of it go because it ain't me. I'm free. I can develop my own lifestyle. So you have a child that was an orphan that probably didn't really know their parents, maybe a little bit, but they start all over from scratch. And see, you and I are in a beautiful place because nobody can claim we did anything to them unless we was instructed by white folks in their army. But we as a people have not done nothing to nobody. We've only been victims. Nobody can say, oh, you enslaved us. We did this. Nobody can say that about us as a people. I said as a people, individuals don't count. I'm talking about as a people. So brothers and sisters, we have not done nothing to nobody. Unless we was obeying Massa. Go fight in Vietnam. Go fight in North Korea, Korea. Go fight in the Middle East, Afghanistan, whatever. But we as a people, we have no blood on our hands. And because of our experience, if you truly understood who and what you are, I'm not talking about that religious, that stuff that you have adopted. I'm talking about if you really understood how you were formed and how we come into being, we are in the best position to not be better, not to be superior, but we're in the best position to show humanity itself how to develop, how to create the heaven on earth that the God talks about in the Bible and Quran. That's what you were developed for. You can do that. And because of our 400 year visit in hell, we've earned that right. and we have qualified to lead humanity to a better place. If you really knew and understood who you are, it has nothing to do with some foreigner's religious books. It's understanding yourself and truly becoming awakened, truly understanding, coming to the conscious, truly becoming a free man and a free woman. You regurgitate, you copy. That's why you don't understand Angel Snub Nub 7. And you still a slave, a feral slave. But even a feral animal, they develop their own. If you release chickens, if you release pigs and cows, and just let them loose, they develop their own. And that's animals going on instinct. Here you are, a human being, able to reason, be analytical and think logically. And you gotta copy somebody. But a feral cat and a feral pig and a feral dog, they do their own thing because they free. These animals don't look at other animals. I want to be like so-and-so. They live their own unique life. You don't want your own uniqueness. You don't care about your own originality. You want to copy somebody. So you talk about legacy, a black legacy. You have no black legacy. Black legacy belongs to white folks. Because black is a European classification. That's their stuff. Michael Jackson, son of Jack, his legacy is really their legacy. It's very simple. And they will even tell you, black history is part of white history. It don't belong to you. It belongs to them. So your legacy is not even yours. And you carry their name. Jackson, son of Jack. Johnson, son of John. Whoever the hell these people are. Or maybe you Muhammad. Your legacy is part of them. You give nothing to yourself. You give nothing to yourself. You view yourself as an inferior. Everybody better than you. But you are God. You are God, but you bow down to Arabs or Africans or people from the islands or Chinese or the European. You bow down to everybody. Legacy. So what kind of legacy are you building? The legacy of a slave. That's your legacy. That's not my fault. I'm just keeping it real. And you know that what I'm saying is real. You still their slave. You still Toby. Ain't nothing changed. But now you're a rich nigga. You're a nigga with generational wealth. But you still Toby. Or maybe you Mohammed. Or Yashara Elo. Or Ekeline Bey or something like that. You somebody's slave. What is wrong with you developing your own originality, your own uniqueness? That's what this platform is about. I don't want to be them. They don't impress me. And the thing about it is, if you want to be them, you're going to have to accept the evil that they have done, because none of these suckers is holy and righteous. A lot of these people are slave masters, murderers, rapists. And that's what you want to be. So be it. But those who want to love yourself and see value in yourself and concentrate on your own, our own self-development, we don't need them. Why would our ancestors suffer for 400 years just to be like the slave master, their enemy? A good name is better than gold. Nothing better than a name that came from me. Because I'm just as smart, I'm just as intelligent as any African or any European or any of these other suckers, any Israelite, ancient Moor, whatever the hell. I'm smarter. Matter of fact, those people don't even exist no more. So how the hell they gonna be smarter and greater than me when they're dead? You gotta make up stuff for them because they can't speak for themselves. Grave robbers. So this platform is like the Jesus that bring life, life-giving teachings, bringing life. You said life, but you represent death, the non-living, evil. And when you hear some of them talk, they sound just like a slave owner. Murderers. Violent, nasty, a bunch of disgusting freaks. I don't have to believe in God, but I embrace what we call righteous behavior. I embrace righteous behavior not because I'm scared of God, because it's beneficial to me. It's good for me. I don't want your liquor. I don't want your crack. I don't want your strip clubs. I don't need that stuff because it's bad for me. Not because, oh, that's a sin. No, because it's bad for me. I want to have a good relationship with a woman. And I want to be faithful. I want to be true. Not because it's a sin. Because that's good. That's good for us as a people. That's good for us as individuals. That's good for the children that's growing up. It's good for our society. It's destructive when people live in hurt and pain, whether it is physically or mentally. You don't know yourself. If only you could develop yourself and see who and what you really are. I'm not impressed by this stuff because I understand who and what I am. You really don't understand who and what you really are. So that stuff impressed you. They don't impress. The Quran don't impress me. The Bible don't impress me. What they did in African Kemet and Timbuktu, that don't impress me. Behold, I make all things new. That's why they don't impress me. Because the former things pass away. Again, I could be in error. I could be off base. I still have a little time. Come on here and show me that I'm off base. I know you can. The only thing you can do is agree. A wise person would say, I hear you, brother. We got to do better. That's what a wise person would say, because it's true. What I've been saying is true. It's facts. Anything other is denial. And if you're happy on the slave plantation, if you're happy playing in the cemetery, so be it. But don't come around me smelling like decomposition. Woo! Stinking. Because I'm gonna have to tell you, hey, you smell. I try to do it nice, but you stink. You've been playing in the graveyard. You got flies buzzing around you. You got the vultures in the air. So there's no black legacy. Because a slave, oppressed people, somebody under another person's rule, you don't have no legacy. It belonged to somebody else. You carry their name, living under another people. If it's not the white folks, you giving your stuff to somebody else. So how is it your legacy? Whatever comes from this platform is my legacy. Nobody gets no credit for nothing. It's mine. You want to give yours to other folks and dead folks that you don't even know from millions of years ago or whatever. Because you their slave. I'm free. I don't belong to nobody. And I'm going to act like, I'm going to talk like I'm a free person and do what free people are supposed to do. Develop mine. How are you developing yours when you connected to another man's ding-a-ling? Because when you carry their names, whether it comes from the Bible or from wherever, that's their ding-a-ling. That's not yours. It's not your legacy. Michael Jackson, son of Jack. Michael Jackson's legacy belonged to Jack. And Michael Jackson himself gave his legacy to outside of his own. He gave it all to Jack. So Michael Jackson has nothing. It all goes to Jack. The Jacksons don't have nothing. All of it goes to whoever Jack is. Johnson, son of John. John get it all. Because that's the slave master. He's still part of you. Or if it's not them, you want to give it to Abdullah, Lakeem, or Lakeem, or whatever. Anything except yourself. Because you think that's you too. That's not you. That's your masa. Voluntary and involuntary. And I'm not nobody's slave. I would rather have no legacy. I'd rather have no legacy if the only thing I can leave is all my work goes to some foreigner, slave owners, and my behavior is that of a coward and a beggar. Oh, please, Kamala Harris, help us. Oh, Kamala Harris, help us. Oh, Donald Trump, help us. Beggar, cowards. The legacy of being a grown man, you're a child. Because that's the current legacy that you have. You rich and you got generation, you have generational wealth, but you're a rich nigga. And the only one you're going to impress is another slave. I'm not your slave. That's why I don't care how much money you have. I don't care who you think you are. You can't impress me because I understand that you're nothing but a slave. And you don't impress white folk. You don't even impress these migrants coming across the border. You don't impress them. Because in less than 10 years, they probably have what you got and more within the next 10 years. That shows you how pitiful you are. Your legacy. And that's the reality of it. Truth hurts. Again, I could be in error. I could be in error. Please help me. If I'm in error, please help me. I know I intimidate folks or whatever, but I want to be right. So help me. Don't make mockery of me. Don't say, oh, brother, you. No, I will be quiet. People come here all the time. I'll be quiet, let you talk. And help me. Cause I'm lost. I'm lost, y'all. I admit I'm lost. I just be talking some stuff. I'm lost. Can somebody help me? Can somebody please help me? Come here and teach us. I'll let you talk as long as you want to and teach. Straighten me up, please. But now you got some questions. You got some interrogation. They don't like that word, interrogation. Yes, I call it interrogation because it's criminal when you lie to somebody. That's why I love the word interrogation. Because it's criminal when you come to people and you knowingly lie to them. With that said, we're going to get out of here. Shout out to our chat room. Shout out to Mellow Cap. Shout out to our brother 47. Thank you so much for joining us in the chat room. We are simulcasting on Angel Snuffed Up 7 YouTube channel, Facebook, Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry, Facebook and all its affiliates. And this is Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry YouTube channel. I appreciate it. Thank you so much for joining us. I had to talk about this topic because I've seen so many brothers on Facebook talk about my legacy. My legacy. What you talking about? Your legacy. My biological blood and all this nonsense that don't mean nothing. It don't mean nothing when you are under the rule of another man. It means nothing. Your legacy in reality don't even belong to you. It belongs to them. On that note, we're going to get out of here. Thank you so much again for joining us on this spontaneous broadcast. And I don't know when the next broadcast. It'll probably be spontaneous also. But it's always an honor that you would come and give us a few moments of your time to listen to what we have to say. I appreciate it. And again, and I say this over and over again, I could be in error. I could be wrong. Come here and show your brother, cause I was lost. I lost. I don't know what they write. I don't know what I'm talking about here. I lost. Come and help your brother. What you scared of? I tell you what you're scared of. Scared of the real truth. Scared of reality. And that's why they're not going to come here and mess with me. Because they know what the deal is. So on that note, we're going to go ahead and get out of here. Thank you for listening. Jot down your comments, subscribe. Those, if you want to make an Angel Snuffing Up channel, do so. And those of you who don't know about the Mississippi campaign, just do a Google search, because I have it on Facebook, I have it on Rumble, I have it here. Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign for dummies. That's probably one of the best videos, compilations that I put together. And if you don't understand the Mississippi campaign after how I broke it down, you don't want to know. And I give our brother, Pharaoh Said That, shout out to Pharaoh Said That in his platform. That man just automatically saw what it was. Now, you don't have to support it or do anything, but don't go out here and that ain't gonna work and blah, blah, blah. Because we know the vision is quite clear. Give the vision, give the proposal its respect. Because you're not gonna come here and challenge me with that stuff that you've been doing for the last 50 years. We know, ain't did nothing in the last 50 years. We need something strong, we need something new. We need to free our mind. We need to start living and get up out of this graveyard. Let's get out of here. Like our ancestor, Dr. Cornelius, used to say, as important, I wish us love, peace, and soul. And we are already 5,000.